Hello and welcome to Buzz Plays. In this episode, I'm going to show you guys the new Druid forms that are being introduced in Mists of Pandaria. Also, I'll try and go through all the armored forms at the end of this video, but I'm going to have to kind of edit it together because there is a 3-minute cooldown on the actual ability. So to start with, you get your bear form, which is your standard bear form, and you've got your cat, which is your standard cat form. Now, with the new talents, we've got Glyph of the Stag, which actually transforms you into a stag and also gives you the ability to let one of your party members actually mount you, and you can be used as a mount. So we will show you this one first. So there you go. Cool looking stag. Nice big antlers. Now these guys have got a few commands. I'm not sure of all of them, but you've got sleep. So he actually lies down and goes to sleep, which is pretty cool. And also that's the same animation for lie, for when you lie down. You've also got dance. And there you go, there's a little jig. Nice little dance for you. You've got your running animation. And also your walking animation. So there you go. Pretty cool animations. Like I said, I think there are a few more, but I'm not sure what the commands are for them. Next up is you've got another glyph now, which is of the Ent, and it just teaches you the ability to shapeshift into a tree Ent if you want to, which is your old style tree Ent, and you can basically cast all your normal spells as well as your healing spells through this. It's not got any extra abilities or anything like that, as far as I'm aware. Again, bog standard commands, so it's old style dance. Right, and sleep. So, yeah. That's just your normal commands there that you had when he was originally in the game. Your next one, again, which is another glyph, is Glyph of the Orca, and this actually transforms your swimming seal into an orca. So let's go into the water, and here we go. There you go. So again, there's no extra abilities, it's just literally cosmetic look of your swimming form. I think on my druid that I have got, I'll probably be using this glyph just because I think it looks cool. And I do actually like orcas. So yeah. So if we come back out, I will show you guys the cheetah. First off, the cheetah glyph, sadly I couldn't seem to find it. I believe there's a guy that actually spawns where you can buy the glyphs off of them, but I'm not sure when or where he spawns. If I find him, I will bring you this the cheetah glyph at the end of the video, but I can't promise on that one, sadly. Next one I'll show you is Glyph of the Chameleon. So if we just go over the stag at the moment and put a chameleon in, basically what this glyph does is each time you shapeshift into a cat or the bear form, it actually changes the colour of your hair. So if we go into bear form, you can see he's purple, and also the cat is purple. But if we transform into the bear again, transfers to black, transforms to black's eye. And again, the cat goes to a grey, and then you've got a brown bear. So you get the gist, basically. Every time you change form into a bear or a cat, it actually changes colour of your fur, which is another pretty cool glyph. If you get fed up with the same colour, bear or cat forms. Next up, I'll show you is stars, which is the it transforms your moonkin to look more ancestral, astral. So if we just change spec a second and activate that one. So when you go into your boomkin form to start with, obviously you look like a giant chicken with antlers. Whereas if we put on the stars glyph, you can see you come out of your moonkin form, and then if we transform into him again, you can see you basically have fallen stars all around you, a nice little puddle animation on the floor, and you don't look like a giant chicken. So I can see a lot of people who don't like the moonkin form having this glyph. I mean, it looks pretty cool. If I was a my druid is actually a tank and fel, so but if I had it, I would definitely use this glyph. Now, if we just come off, take it off a second, and what I'll do is I will show you a new talent. Now, is this called incarnation? This is the one where I'm going to have to cut a lot of the videos out while I wait for the cooldown so I can show you each of these. So there will be a lot of transitions, so I do apologize for that, but I thought you guys might want to see these. So if we start as I'm on this spec anyway, if I show you the Boomkin or Moonkin, whatever you'd like to call him, what he would look like once if you use this talent. So if we transform into the Moonkin and then use the incarnation, there you go, that's what he looks like there. Got some armor on him, looks a bit more tougher. It'd be nice if this was actually a form you can stay in, but sadly it's not, as I think it's only 25 seconds you get. So what I'll do now is I will cut here and bring you the next form. As I said, sorry for all the cutting, but this is the only way really that I could show you guys all the different forms. So I'll be back in a second. Right, and now on this one, I have changed my spec to I believe it's fel. Yep, fel. And on this one, I will show you the armored cat form using incarnation. So here we go. There you go. That's your cat form with the armor on. Again, really cool. Shame you can't keep them like that. They do look. I prefer them with the armor on than when they haven't got it on, actually. So yeah, that's what your cat looks like with the armor on. Again, I will cut here, and I will then bring you the bear form. And hopefully, while I go to do that, I can find the guy to sell the cheetah one, if I can find him. So again, 3 minutes from me, but I will see you in a second. Right, and this time I will be showing you guys the bear form using incarnation, and then after that we'll have one more cut where I will show you the balance, I believe it is. No, restoration, sorry. I'll show you the restoration form. So here we go. Hit incarnation, and there you go. That's your bear form with the armor on. As I said, with the cat, and also on the Moonkin. I do prefer the armor. They look better. It's just a shame it's a 25-second spell. But yeah, it looks pretty cool. You see it on the bear there as well. And again, as I said, I will cut here, and I will then show you the restoration form, I've had another look around to see if I could find this glyph of the cheetah, but I can't find it. While I'm waiting for this cooldown, I will have another look. And I will see you in a second. And for the last form, which I believe is just a bog standard Tree of Life, or the new looking Tree of Life, but you need this spell, I believe, to go into it now. So, Incarnation, there you go, that's your Tree of Life look. As I said, it's only, I think it's 25 seconds, 30 second cooldown. And I believe now to get into this form, you have to have Incarnation. I could be wrong, but yeah, so that's your new Tree of Life spell. You can come out of it and then you can go back in it as many times as you want. So yeah, sadly, I couldn't find the glyph of the cheetah to show you. Hopefully, if I find it before this goes live, I will bring it to you. But as the talents and stuff are coming live today and tomorrow, you guys will probably see all the forms and that anyway. So thanks for watching, and see you all next time.